Good afternoon. Today we're going to talk about Lay's and what is the brand analysis and the development of this product. The group is conformed by Alba Sanchez, Carla Acuria, Antonio Wareham, and Patricio González. These are the topics we're going to cover: product description, cultural changes, cultural target and audience strategies, the support of strategies and tactics in the product, examples of the brand, and the limitation of the global strategies. The product description. Lay's was able to create a chip that was made with selected potatoes with the highest quality and standards. As well, they were able to implement the history of the brand. The history: Lay's is considered one of the biggest multinational companies in the world. It was founded in Nashville, Texas, by Herman Lay's in 1932. After a post-war period, Lay's suffered from a dramatic output within their factory. By this particular reason, they were able to develop a product that could satisfy a large scale of customers. Lay's was one of the first brands to develop a flavor differentiation on their chips. For example, their most popular flavor in 1950 was the cheese and onion flavor. In order to develop a flavor, in order to create a trend on the nation. The brand names. Lay's is considered one of the best-selling products under association of PepsiCo. The company PepsiCo and Frito-Lay merged in 1965. Lay's was named after the original creator, Herman Lay. The main company, Lay's, however, is marketing to different brand names across the globe, which influenced by the different languages and cultural backgrounds. For example, we have Argentina with Franchitas, Mexico Sabritas, Colombia with Margarita, Israel with Tapuchis, and Egypt with Chispi. Analysis of cultural changes. We chose demographics, attitudes of work, religion, attitudes of females and males in the roles, and political factors. Demographics. In the United States, more than 160 million Americans consume Lay's on a daily basis. The demographics are challenged, as the brand is known to consume all around the world. They are differentiated by cultural, race, and traditions. The brand is able to adapt with different types of flavors in order to gain customers' needs and wants. The attitude in work. Lay's is considered to have a good internal environment within the organization due to the fact that they are looking for them to maintain an internal status. The internal environment in the management and production line is friendly and highly adaptable to the integration, as they are required to rotate employees across the globe to create strategies to maximize profitability. Religion. The company is able to differentiate and adapt products in different countries. For example, in Bangladesh, most of the population is Muslim, as they are required to provide halal products. The attitudes towards female and male roles. Lay's is able to maintain a good ethical environment. They are required to have a certain percentage of females and males across the organization to give opportunity to any minority. They are considered to be ethical as they focus on becoming a natural and organic, as well as transforming into a pet packaging. The political factors. Public expenses such as taxes. Lay's needed to analyze the political stability of the desired country, and governments are an authorization to give grants and subsidies and loans in order to create a link of communication between the company and the government. As well, Lay's operates in a high role of employees.
Well known throughout the world, the United States stands out for its hypercaloric meals, fast food, and snacks. Currently, 18% of the entire US population suffers from severe obesity. Sauce, condiments, and spices form their daily diet. Therefore, it's not surprising that Lay's top sales in the United States are led by the plain chips flavor, followed by the barbecue flavor, then sour cream and onions, and the fourth and fifth place is occupied by salt, vinegar, and cheese. The United Kingdom is one of the most important countries for the sale of snacks. That is why it is positioned in the sixth place that consume most Lay's around the world. Regarding the flavors preferred by British consumers, in the first position is cheese and onions, two very common elements in the British culinary culture. In second position would be ready salted, and in third place in the ranking, salt and vinegar. It is also important to mention the fact that in the UK, Lay's adopt the name Walkers. This is because Frito-Lay bought the Walkers brand in 1991, which had been working in this country for more than 40 years and was deeply rooted in the society, and Lay's decided not to change the name. In Mexico, chips are part of the daily gastronomy. According to a study carried out, 97% of Mexican households invest a minimum of 500 pesos per year. And it is estimated that each Mexican person consumes an average of 3 kilograms of chips per year. It is also important to mention that Frito-Lays are called Sabritas, a combination of tasty and fried. The ranking of flavors in Mexico has in the first place original salted, secondly cheese, in third position crunchy jalapeño chips, the next position we find flaming hot, and lastly habanero flavor. Not only the spiciest flavor predominate, but the most traditional way of eating these snacks is to add in hot sauce that comes in the bag itself. China is one of the most important markets for Lay's, not only because of the high numbers of customers, but also because of the exotic flavors that you can find for this snack. There is so much variety, and sometimes many people buy the bags with the most striking flavors as souvenirs. In the ranking of flavors in the Chinese market, the American classic flavor occupied the first place, followed by Nam and spicy hot pot. Then we find Italian red meat and little tomato, and in fifth place, hot and sour fish soup. Seafood is a staple in the diet of Southeast Asian countries, so it's not a big surprise that the flavors of the sea dominate Lay's varieties in this region. Thailand is one of the countries within the top 10 for sales of Lay's. Consumers base their diet on food from the sea, which are cooked with a large amount of spices, which cause a very intense flavor in the daily diet. These culinary tastes are what Lay's use to base the flavors of its products. Therefore, the flavors that lead the Thai market are spicy squid in second place, teriyaki salmon in third position. It is followed by the flavor of pad thai with shrimp, and in the fifth place we find green curry with chicken. But without a doubt, the best selling flavor in Thailand is sweet basil, since the spice is essential in its daily cuisine, which is used in the most of traditional recipes of the country.
In order to make Lay's develop as a global brand, we came up with four main strategies. The first strategy we propose for Lay's is the creation of an international competition. First of all, Lay's will create a platform in which its customers can create a profile, and for each bag of chips that they buy, they will be able to vote for their favorite flavor by entering the barcode. In this way, we can create a competition between customers who vote for their favorite flavor, and in turn, we are promoting the purchase of products. By doing this, we will create an interactive platform for Lay's customers worldwide. The votes will be updated every day, and it will be of international interest to see which flavor would be preferred around the world. The second one will be creating a campaign on social networks to promote a new product, organic classic chips. Since there has been an increase in purchases of organic products due to the fact that people are becoming aware of the importance of eating natural and non-transgenic products. The next strategy that we present has the function of creating a unique and individual environment for Lay's consumers. We propose the option of being able to customize the bag for different events such as birthdays, parties or anniversaries, in addition to being able to combine these new bag designs by also adding a personalized photograph. In this way, we will ensure that consumers not only have the option of eating the bag of chips in 20 or 30 minutes, but that they can keep the bag for years to always remember that special moment with their closest loved ones and Lay's. The last strategy would be launching a new product called Movie, Lay's and Chill. These chips will have popcorn flavor. For a few years now, the growing success of Netflix has influenced the way of life of all people. Is there anyone in the world who hasn't used Netflix? With this new product, we will not be offering a few simple chips, but we will be offering the complete experience, relax, watch Netflix, and eat some delicious popcorn flavored chips that make you feel like you are at the cinema. We have carried out this SWOT analysis in order to design the strategies on which the company will rely to face its future in the short, medium, and long term. It is a map through which the weaknesses, threats, strengths, and opportunities of the organization are established. On strengths, we have the customer satisfaction, worldwide known products, the amazing marketing on social media that they have, which is individualized for each country, and the support from PepsiCo Group. The weaknesses are days inventory is too high. This causes them to lose capital and can affect long-term growth. On the other hand, they don't have a good forecast of the demand that the products will have. This is directly related to the inventory, since if a good estimate is not made in the demand, the products will remain longer than expected. On opportunities, new markets that haven't been conquered, such as organic products, and growth in the consumption of salty sweets worldwide. And lastly, the threats are that being a company that operates throughout the world, they must be very aware of the legal changes that may occur in each country. And the increase in the cost of raw materials would negatively affect Lay's, since their products cannot be expensive.
My name is Antonius, and based on certain case examples and brand stories, I would like to portray the efficient cultural strategies Lay's used to gain customers' attention and to establish itself in the market. A good example of how Lay's caught the attention of the European market was through a well-thought marketing campaign by paying extra attention on the cultural aspects of most European countries. This was done by sponsoring the UEFA Champions League and a cooperation with Lionel Messi. It is widespread that soccer is considered the most popular sport in all age groups in Europe, with millions of fans. This led to a high level of attention towards the company. Furthermore, many young people identify and admire the football star Lionel Messi and would do anything to be like him. This intelligence strategy plays Lay's well ahead of their competition. Moreover, in the US and other Western countries, the 9-to-5 average working day is a reality for most people, and most are too tired to deal with anything other than television, Netflix and co. when returning home later in the evening. Since chips are one of the favorite snacks when relaxing in the evening, Lay's has generally caught the right market. In addition, the various types of chips offer a welcome change from the competition. In addition, establishing themselves as brand ambassadors for non-profit campaigns such as Jordan Sparks and Operation Smile, as well as organizing donation campaigns for every bag purchased, gained the favor of Western culture consumers who pay special attention to companies' values and what they stand for. Through advertisement across Twitter, Facebook and YouTube, Lay's targets young buyers who will build their future customer base and who identify with those social media platforms. A marketing strategy is certainly not a single method that fits and suits every market. Therefore, I would like to explain the limitations and difficulties of those global brand strategies, as well as suggest improvements. Sponsoring the UEFA Champions League and a cooperation with Lionel Messi took Lay's an enormous amount of capital, a lot of research, energy and time, which represented a big risk. However, they did their job well and paid off in the end. I suggest Lay should pay close attention to what works well for the competition in order to gain an insight what customers are attracted to. The challenge Lay's is facing with social media marketing and promoting their newest product is to identify the target audience and to deliver the right message to them. It is essential to identify the correct target group in order to avoid damage to the brand's credibility. I suggest to create a custom avatar from the information and data collected, for example from ad analytics, existing customer base and email subscriber list. Personalized bags provide numerous benefits for Lay's and their customers. However, this method also portrays some disadvantages. In the age of aggressive competition, the consumers expect a lot from a company, and it is essential to market and produce the right bags for certain customers and cultural groups. In order to be efficient, there is a fine line between interesting, attention-grabbing and morally questionable. I suggest to pay extra attention to market research, what is well received by customers by analyzing data such as their preferences, individual tastes, as well as colors and images that are particularly appealing in certain cultural areas. Thank you.